Over the last 2 years, more than 400,000 people have been laid off and data scientists' roles were affected. So why should you become a data scientist in 2024? This is what somebody would tell you to discourage you from becoming a data scientist. Yes, data scientists' roles were affected by the layoff, but when you zoom out and look at the bigger picture, you will see less than 10% of the roles that were laid off belong to data scientists. 28% belong to HR and recruiting, and 22% software engineering. Yes, there were more software engineers laid off than data scientists. Yes, the job market is still soft and it will take some time to catch up, but this also makes it a good time to start learning data science. In this video, I'm going to be sharing a complete roadmap that you can use to learn data science and land a job. So what does a data scientist do? A data scientist takes the data, turns it into powerful information that helps businesses succeed. Now, this is a very simple definition, and after watching this video, you will actually have a really good understanding what this definition means. And if somebody were to come to you and ask you, what does a data scientist do? You'll be able to explain it. A typical data scientist project involves a few steps. It typically starts with data collection, data processing, exploratory data analysis, short for EDA, feature engineering, model development, model evaluation, model deployment, and iteration. So before we jump into the roadmap, there's one exercise that I want all of you to do. I want you to research the data science job family and look at all the roles that are under the data science umbrella. There is typically a few roles that stand out under the data science job family: data scientist, data analyst, machine learning engineer, AI specialist, data engineer, analytics manager, research scientist, and many more. One of the mistakes that I made when I started learning data science is I only focused on the data scientist role. And back then, I didn't know that so many other job roles exist in the data science space, and I could have considered it if I had known about it. So what I would like you to do is become familiar with all the roles that are available and figure out what would you enjoy doing, what is your target looks like before you actually jump into the data scientist role itself. Because there is a lot of learning involved and it will take time. So you don't want to waste your time. You want to make sure like you are fully dedicated to learning data science before you commit to it, because it will take a lot of hard work. Let's say you have figured out you want to become a data scientist generalist. So the next thing I want you to do, I want you to narrow down the companies and the roles that you would be interested in. Then I want you to go to their career website. Let's say you want to work at Meta as a data scientist. I want you to go to Meta's career website and look at data scientist role, look at the job description and understand what type of candidate they are looking for, what skill set they are asking for, what hard skills and soft skills that they require. Is it a lot of experimentation? Is it a lot of machine learning? Because that will give you a better idea of what you need to learn, and it will help you define your roadmap and customize it. Take notes of all of this. Then I want you to go on LinkedIn and search for people who are already working as a data scientist at Meta. Look at their profile, look at their education history, look at the type of work that they're doing, and take note again, because we're going to be using this throughout the roadmap. So let's say you have narrowed down that data scientist role is what you want to pursue. You have also done your research and you're ready to go. A lot of data scientist roadmaps tell you to start learning Python as the first thing, but I completely disagree with this advice. And here's why. Coding, including Python and SQL, are tools to apply data science. They're not data science by themselves. I'm going to say this again. Coding is a way to apply data science. It's not data science by itself. What data science actually is statistics and machine learning. So that's the first skill I want you to learn. Because let's say if you start learning statistics and machine learning and you realize like this is not for you, then I would want you to stop and not pursue it further. Because in order to be successful as a data scientist, you need to have the basic fundamental. Coding is a tool to apply statistics and machine learning. So what I want you to do is start building your foundation with statistics and machine learning. For statistics, I would recommend that you learn descriptive and inferential statistics. So descriptive statistics is basically understanding what the data looks like. And there are several methods that you need to understand in order to learn descriptive statistics. It includes like measurement of central tendency, basically mean, median, mod, measurement of variability, such as like standard deviation, variance, frequency distribution, measurement of shape, how skewed the data is, and graphical summaries, basically bar plots and so on. The next, I want you to learn inferential statistics. And this is where it starts becoming fun. Learn probability distribution, hypothesis testing, one of my favorite subjects, Bayesian versus frequentist statistics, sampling, time series analysis, experiment design, multivariate analysis, ANOVA, survival analysis, bootstrap, resampling. So these are some of the concepts that you need to know in order to have your basics done in statistics. Next, we're going to focus on machine learning. Machine learning, divide the subjects into two focus areas. One is supervised machine learning, and then the next is unsupervised machine learning. So the first, we're going to focus on supervised learning. For supervised learning, we're going to focus on linear regression and logistic regression. Make sure you know these models in and out because these two models coming up in an interview is very, very, very common. Continuing on the supervised learning, then there is decision trees, random forest, neural network, deep learning. Now, again, if you have done the research and looked at the role, you would understand how much machine learning is required. So you might not need to go as in depth into these machine learning models depending on the job family or depending on the company and the role that you're targeting. But again, if you want to do a lot of machine learning, then you definitely should learn all of these things. Under unsupervised learning, focused on k-means clustering, hierarchical clustering, principal component analysis, this one specifically, and k-means clustering, I've seen quite a bit come up in interviews along with these topics. Understand these concepts well. There are several online sources that you can use to learn statistics and machine learning. For statistics, I specifically love using Khan Academy, as well as a YouTube channel called StatQuest that you can watch videos and learn statistics. There are several books that you can read and also use ChatGPT and Google where you don't understand. One of my favorite things with ChatGPT is that I ask it to explain complex subjects as if it was explaining to a child, and it does a really, really good job. Some of these subjects can be difficult to understand, so use all the resources at your hands and to get a solid understanding of all the statistics and machine learning. So let's say you have figured out your fundamentals. Now it's time to apply these skills. Remember I said coding is a tool to apply statistics and machine learning? So now that you know statistics and machine learning, you're going to apply it. And this is where you need to learn coding so you can apply the skills that you have learned. So for coding, hands down, learn Python and SQL. When I started learning data science, I started with R. I worked with R for 2 years and then I switched to Python. One of the things my team realized early on, well, not early on, after 2 years of doing this, that it was really hard to communicate with the engineering team. Taking our R code and then deploying it was very difficult and it increased our project lifespan. Anyways, I have covered this topic in a different video. You can watch this video to see why I prefer Python over R. For Python, you should understand how to do data analysis in Python, know libraries such as Pandas, NumPy, Matplotlib. For machine learning, you should know Python libraries such as scikit-learn, TensorFlow, PyTorch, depending on the model that you're using. There's so many videos available online, so many resources online where you can learn Python. The next coding language that you should learn is SQL. You will be using SQL quite a bit when you are accessing the data because most of the times the data is sitting in a database. So understand how to write SQL, know how to join the data set. You should know all the joins, left, right, outer, inner, select statement, how to filter your data, how to do aggregate functions, and how to do subqueries, how to do advanced analytics functions. So by now you have statistics and machine learning covered, you have coding, you know Python and SQL. The next thing you're going to focus on is learning the tools. So for tools, what I would recommend is that you understand how to work with notebooks such as Jupyter Notebook and Google Colab Notebooks, because chances are that you're going to be using those for doing your data science work, writing your code there, and doing most of your data science project there. Understand how the code review process works, because the chances are that at your job, you will be following the code review process. So learn all the Git commands and understand it fully, how it works and how you can push the code, how you can pull the code, how you can deploy the code and things like that. And obviously these tools would vary depending on the company that you end up. So I'm not trying to focus too much on this right now, because you will eventually end up learning more tools as you start doing your work as a data scientist. Let's say you don't want to become a data scientist and you want to become a data analyst. In that case, I wanted to share this data analytics program by Career Foundry, who is also sponsoring this section of the video. The program has elements of generative AI, so it not only teaches you data analytics, but also teaches you how to use generative AI in your day-to-day work to be more productive and work smarter. The learning material is organized in three segments. First, you get intro to data analytics and cover various topics. Then data immersion, which is hands-on experience on all the topics that you have learned so far. Again, great way to learn anything new is learn something and then apply. This is what I really like about this program. And lastly, you get to pick a specialization. You either get to pick data visualization with Python or machine learning specialization. This is amazing because the specialization allows you to go deeper into specific data analytics topic.
You'll get access to expert mentors and tutors and get to graduate with a professional portfolio in data analytics. And most importantly, there's job guarantee that ensures that you land a job within 6 months of graduation or they will refund your tuition.
Use the link below to learn more and get 20% off. Now let's go back to the video. So by now you have statistics and machine learning fundamentals done. You know coding, you know the tools. Now I want you to spend some time learning the business fundamentals and product fundamentals. This step is specifically important because what differentiates a good data scientist from a great data scientist is having a solid business understanding, having a solid product understanding, so you can build solution that is helping the bottom line of the business and the product. understand how the product thinks, how the product development lifecycle works, and how you will plug in as a data scientist into these products and this business area to help them grow and succeed. Because knowing, having a good business and product understanding will make you a superstar data scientist. And on the topic of superstar, you need to also have solid communication skills, because the chances are that when you do your project, at the start and at the end of the project, you will be communicating with business, you will be communicating with engineering, you will be communicating with product and many other job families. So for you to be a great data scientist, you need to have a really good communication skills where you can communicate to a tech audience and a non-tech audience. So get really good practice, whether that is doing in a presentation form or doing it in a written form. Having good communication skills will help you grow in your career way further than somebody who does not have these communication skills. And we're gonna practice this when we build the project portfolio. So let's say you have the basics done, you know statistics and machine learning, you can solve problems by applying these fundamentals using the tools that we mentioned. You have a good communication, you can understand how product and business think. Now I want you to apply these skills by doing projects. This is going to help you in two ways. It's going to help solidify your knowledge, and second, it's going to help you stand out on your resume when recruiters are looking on it. 5 is typically a good number of projects that you can focus on. You can do more or less. Just make sure that they are representing the skills that you know. I remember we took notes at the start of the video where you looked at the job description and you looked at the people who are already working there. This will give you a good idea what type of work they are looking for, what type of work these people have done to help them get a job at your target company, which in this case is Meta. So now you'll figure out what kind of project you're going to do. For example, one of the things that stood out to you was probably a lot of experimentation and A/B testing. So one of the projects that you will do here is around hypothesis testing, including experimentation design, doing the analysis, and then presenting insights and recommendations from that hypothesis testing. The second project, let's say you can focus on time series forecasting. Third project could be customer fraud detection. This is a classification problem. The fourth project, let's say you build a recommender system. The fourth project, I guess we're in the fourth project, you can do some EDA, exploratory data analysis, and do some feature engineering. So build your project portfolio in a way that shows unique skill set in each project. So a recruiter reading your resume can tell that, okay, you know all of these things. If you're looking for data set, there are so many free data sets available on websites such as Kaggle and Google Data Search. You can find free data set there and start doing your projects. Now, we're not done yet. In order to land the job, let's say you've done the projects and it's helping you get the calls for the interviews. Now, getting the call for the interviews is not enough. You actually need to sit down in the interview and pass the interview in order to get the job. So this is why I want you to do the interview prep. Responding in an interview setting in front of a stranger in a time-constrained setting can be nerve-wracking. I have personally blanked out in interviews on concepts that I knew very, very well. So this is why getting practice on these interview questions is very important. For data scientist interview, I typically like to divide it into 3 segments. 1 is behavioral, 2 is coding, and then 3 is fundamentals on statistics and machine learning. Under statistics and machine learning, a lot of case study focused interview prep. For example, they can give you a problem in the interview. They can say, we want to improve our customer churn rate. Tell me what exactly you will do. They obviously will not give you very clear problem like I just gave. They will give you a lot vague problem. They would expect you to define the problem and then solve it using a solution that you would have to pick, and you will have to tell the pros and cons and show why you actually picked that solution. In my opinion, a lot of the time people end up focusing on coding, which is fine, but you also need to have a solid understanding of how to solve these case studies for these specific data science concepts that are the core skill set of a data scientist role. Notice in this video, I did not give you a timeline. I didn't say that you can learn this skill in 3 months or 6 months. Every person has unique needs and unique abilities. It might take you 6 months to do this, but for someone else, it might take them 5 months or it might take them 12 months. So take your time, learn these skills. And if you found value in this video, give this video a thumbs up and let me know in comments your data science journey. And if you have any questions, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one. Bye.